Hello, Wobblies. Welcome to Wobbly Otter Outdoors. I'm Chris, and this is the Roll Top Air Pump by Klymit. In our Smittybilt rooftop tent, we have a 2-inch foam mattress. Sometimes when you lay on your side, it can be uncomfortable on your hip and your shoulders. So we looked around at different solutions. The solution we chose to help make it more comfortable to sleep in the rooftop tent on the foam mattress is to get sleeping pads. And we chose Klymit. We got the Klymit Insulated V sleeping pads, and we've been very happy with it. We use them every time we go out now, and I love them. It takes about 10 to 15 breaths to blow up the Klymit air mattress, and that's fine. It's easy enough to do. When we're moving from campsite to campsite frequently, I found that I came to just not get excited about blowing up the air mattress. Another thing I was concerned about is putting all that moisture into the air mattress for my breath. I went looking for different small air pumps that I could use, and I expected to find something that would fasten over the top that was a little hand pump, foot pump sort of thing, but I wasn't finding anything like that that would fit the push-pull valve that's on the Klymit V. The solution I did find is that Klymit makes a roll top air pump. When I read the reviews about it online, they were very mixed. And the reason they didn't like it was it still took a little bit of time to air up the mattress, even with this bag. Others were having trouble getting the air into the bag. When I received it, the thing that surprised me most about it is it's big. It said it was 18 liters, and that should have been a clue. But my gosh, the thing is huge. So that surprised me. But that's good, because that means it can hold a lot of air. It has a nice opening, and it's just a long tube. On the bottom of it is the receptacle that perfectly fits the push-pull valve. Klymit does make another air pump that fits their flat valve. So the receptacle on the air pump fits over the top of the valve. It's just a little friction hold. There's no clip or anything. And that's it. And then for the air, if there's a breeze, it's ever so helpful because you can use the breeze to help capture the air into the pump. Otherwise, you can just blow across the top of it and it will fill up with air quickly. And then you roll the top. So that's how it works. It's very easy to use. It does take a little time, and it is going to give your forearms a little bit of a workout. So let's see how big it is. Length. It is roughly 57 and a half inches long. Oh, and Klymit says that you can also use this as a stuff sack. It has no latch at the top of the bag, but it would still make a nice little carrying sack. Klymit says its pack size is 4 inches by 2 inches. Looks like the way I roll it up, it's about 4.5, 5 inches long and about 2 inches wide. And little air pump weighs 3.5 ounces. In the comments below, let me know what you think of the air pump. Have you ever used an air pump like this for one of your sleeping pads? Do you think it's worth the trouble? Do you worry about having condensation in your sleeping pad? We look forward to hearing what you have to say, and we'll put a link to this little air pump down in the description below. We truly appreciate you watching and subscribing. Until next time.
Thank you for watching and subscribing to Wobbly Otter Outdoors.